Hello everyone, today we'll be discussing about the features of the service models which are there. So there are various features already we have dealt, which are the features which are said to be present in the service model. So let's check the other things and how they are said to be meant, the various features and what you have to do in the features, that you will be learning today. Okay, so let's check one by one. So first is your message size and structure. When the information is being passed from one end to another end, that message, it will be having its own size when it is being transferred to one end to another end. And on the size also, some restrictions would be there when it is said to be sent over the line. For example, in Gmail, you have its own size of sending the information messages. It has its own size. Okay, your whatever data is there, video you can send from one end to another end, it has certain restrictions. All those restrictions are said to be implemented on the network when you are said to be passing the information from one end to another end. So remember, when your data is being transferred from one end to another end, the most important factor is your size of your data. So bigger size, that bigger size, it has to be splitted over the line. Okay, it may be small also, then also it will be splitted into multiple things over the line. So what a message size, it depends, and even the structure of the model also depends. Okay, if it's a bigger structure, it can manage a much a size, but when it is a small size structure of network, then it can manage only a few size data or messages over the net. Okay, so that important thing is there when the information is being passed, it depends on the size and the structure. So what is the size and structure is? It may transfer the information, either it may be single bit, it may be block of bytes it may consider, or it may be byte stream it may consider. Multiple bytes of data can be sent over the line. So that your data, it can be either transfer of a voice mail or a voice call or any kind of data that it is being transferred. It depends on your network. Okay, when it is voice based, the network, it is becomes a little bit slow. When the information is being passed, it has to catch up the signal and it has to transfer the data to the other end. So that it depends on your particular network and what is the speed and what is the recovery rate it is being given when a voice breakage is there. So those and all, it depends on your structure and the size of your data, what you are said to be sending and receiving. Okay. Then next point is your segmentation and blocking. Your data, whichever data is there, it has to be segmented. Your data, it will be layered. Layered means what? Your data, it is said to be sent from one layer to another layer, and the messages may be too short, too small, whatever it is. It has certain rules and regulations. When a bigger data or message is being received, it will be broken up into smaller blocks, and it will be once again, when it is said to be received at the other end, it will be altered in a certain way that it will be reassembled back. Means if you are sending in 1, 2, 3, 4 in the network, the information change its order from 2, 3, 1, 4, like that it may change. So once again at the other end, it will be reassembled and it will be received. Same way in blocking and unblocking happens. What happens is, when a multiple smaller blocks of information is there, if it can be adjusted into a bigger block, it can be done through the help of blocking and unblocking. Okay, if very small data is there, what do they do is, multiple data is there of different systems, so all those are made into a single block and it will be transferred to that particular system only when it is transfer. Once again it reassembles and it will send. That happens in the segmentation and blocking. So segmentation is, remember, dividing a bigger message into smaller blocks, and when it is received, it will be reassembled. Blocking and unblocking is nothing but, okay, smaller blocks of data is there, that it will be combined into a bigger block, which is there, it will be made sent into that bigger block, and when it is transferred, after transferation, when it is received, it will be unblocked and it will be sent to that particular destination. And this happens. Okay, long message, it will be broken up. This is your segmentation, and this is your what? It is said to be blocking. Means what? A small messages are said to be made into a bigger block. Next is reliability. Mainly, what do you mean by reliability? Is nothing but your data, it is dependent on your network. So that network, it should be error free and without loss it should be, and without duplication your information should be passed to the destination. Okay, that is the most important one. In that you even have the sequencing. Sequencing means what is, when the information is being passed, okay, your information is passed in the same way, or what way it is being passed, whether it is received in the same sequence or it is getting mixed up, that it will be managed by the peer-to-peer protocol, your service model sector. Okay, and your automatic automatic repeat request, ARQ it is called, it's a protocol which will help you out in detecting the errors, retransmission if any problem is there, and sequence number providing, it will be reliable on that particular ARQ which you are using. So examples for this ARQ is your TCP and HDLC, nothing but high level data link control, and TCP transfer control protocol. All these are there in reliability and sequencing. Okay, then pace and flow control, it is the most important one. When your information is being passed from one end to another end, the pace has to be controlled. What do you mean by pace? Is nothing but when the information is being passed, I can't send the data in the faster way, okay, one after the other continuously. If I am sending the information, it gets blocked, your network gets blocked. So at that time the network, it will be having one technology that will help you out in making your pressure on the network to lose some, like make the network receive the information slowly and transfer it in a particular order only. Though the particular sender is sending the information fast, the information it will be received in that particular slow manner only, and it will be transferred over the line. Okay. So when the information is passed, there is a chances of loss of data when the information is being passed, or it may be not be stored in the buffers. So that messages, if you want to store it in a proper way, when it has to be transferred, you have to control the pace. And when the information is being passed, it will be passed from one layer to another layer. So when it is passed from one layer to another layer, it may get lost, and like it may, you may lose your information when it is being passed over the layer. So in that, it has to even manage with the buffering spaces on the layers also, so that it doesn't overflow. Overflow means what? Multiple data, it shouldn't be stored on that particular system only, like that it shouldn't happen. So that it will be controlled by the network only. So when the information is transferred to that particular destination, then only it receives that the information from that particular source. Okay, so that is called as pacing and flow control. Provide back pressure mechanism. Back pressure mechanism, it's nothing but when the information, it starts to flow at a faster rate, what is that it do is it sends back the data for certain amount of time, slows the data, and once again it receives the data. That is called as controlling the transfer, and even availability of the buffers, it will be made through the pace and flow control. Remember that. And in this pace and flow control, it has some of the protocols which are being used, which are those as TCP and HDLC. Here also they are said to be using this concept. And another concept which is being there in the service model network, it's nothing but when the information is being sent, the application involving the audio and voice, those information are said to be temporary. It doesn't remain static for longer period of time. Okay, so those applications, it will, has to be meant to be received to the receiver end in particular time only. It shouldn't be reaching to the destination at a different time. It should be reaching to the destination in that particular time only. It is called as real time. So at that particular moment only it will be reaching. For example, your WhatsApp calls. Okay, your information, it will be reaching that, your video call or voice call, it will reach in that particular time only. It may be delay, a normal delay, means what, a 1 second delay or 2 seconds delay. It doesn't take one hour delay. So that timing factor is important when the information is being passed, and that also is taken care by the service model which is being designed. Okay. And even it takes care of the delay and the jitter which happens when you are using the voice in the video. Okay. And timing recovery protocols, mainly it uses the concept of timestamps.
time stamps is nothing but when I am uploading my voice, when I am uploading my video, it will be having its own time consideration. This much time, this much buffering, this much delay, everything it will be meant at that moment only when you upload your videos. And those are also said to be having the sequence numbering, and the factor of delivery information is there. The delivery of the video, it will be little bit delay to the other end. It receives, but when it is said to be buffering and it is storing on your particular device, it will be slow. So these are said to be called as, remember, your timing factor, it depends on your real-time transfer protocol. Your information which is said to be sending your voice or video, it's a real-time transfer which is being transferred from one end to another end, but it will be having the factor called as delay. Delay means your information, it will be having little bit delay and some disturbance within that. Okay. Multiplexing, as you all know, what is multiplexing? Multiplexing is nothing but your information you are getting from the n number of users, and it will be made into a single one over the layered line, whichever line you are using. And once again, it will be demultiplexed, multiple lines it will be passing to the particular users. It will be using the protocols UDP and IP. UDP user datagram protocol, and IP is internet protocol, your multiplexing. Okay, last part in the features of your service model is, most important one is your privacy. Your information, when it is being passed, it will be private. Private means what? The ensuring that the information transferred cannot be read by others. So means what? Whatever information I am passing, it will be encrypted in such a way within the system that it cannot be read by any other people or cannot be used by any other people. Like that, privacy it is being maintained, and integrity is also being maintained, that it will, whatever information I am passing, it will not be altered, it will not be changed. That is called as integrity and authentication. Okay, it will be verifying the sender and the receiver. Verifying means what? Okay, I want to access, I'll be using my user ID and password. Receiver also uses his own user ID and password, then only he can use that information, you can download whatever it is. It will be based on your sender's capabilities. If you are able to download, you are able to download at the receiver end. Otherwise, he is not giving the permission to download, you cannot download, only you can read. That authority or privacy is being provided by that particular sender or the receiver. Okay, and it will be using a protocol, that is IP security protocol and SSL, service security protocols. Okay, that it will be used. Okay, so these and all are the concept of what do you say, the service model. One is your message structure. Message size and structure is one of your feature. Then you have segmentation and blocking. Then you have reliability and sequencing. Then you have pacing and flow control, timing, then multiplexing and privacy, integrity and authentication are the features of service model. Remember, okay. So we have discussed today. So in next classes, we will be learning about the other concepts related to your service models, automatic service request, everything you will be learning in the future sessions. Okay. Thank you.